Nature is full of incredible and sometimes terrifying creatures, but few are as fascinating as the emerald cockroach wasp, Ampulex compressa. This jewel-toned insect is not only beautiful, but also possesses a gruesome ability. It turns cockroaches into mindless zombies. Unlike most predators that kill their prey outright, the emerald cockroach wasp has evolved a unique method of controlling its victim's behavior, ensuring that its offspring have a live food source. This article delves into the wasp's biology, hunting strategy, and the eerie mechanism behind its zombification of cockroaches. The emerald cockroach wasp is a small, metallic green wasp that belongs to the Ampulacidae family. Its shimmering, iridescent exoskeleton makes it one of the most striking insects in the world. Despite its dazzling beauty, this wasp is a deadly parasite. Measuring about 22 millimeters, 8.7 inches in length, it has long legs, large black eyes, and an elongated curved stinger that plays a crucial role in its hunting strategy. This species is primarily found in tropical regions of Africa, South Asia, and the Pacific Islands. It thrives in warm, humid environments where its preferred host, cockroaches, are abundant. Since cockroaches are highly adaptable and found worldwide, the emerald cockroach wasp has successfully established itself in many regions. The hunting process, zombification, begins. Unlike most wasps that paralyze their prey, Ampulex compressa does something far more sinister. When a female wasp hunts, it specifically targets cockroaches, usually species like the American cockroach, Periplaneta americana. The process of turning a cockroach into a zombie involves a precise sequence of attacks, making this wasp an expert neurosurgeon of the insect world. Step 1. The first sting, temporary paralysis. The wasp starts by attacking the cockroach with a quick sting into its thorax, which contains the nerve ganglia responsible for movement. This initial sting paralyzes the cockroach's front legs for a few minutes, preventing it from escaping while the wasp prepares for the next step. However, this paralysis is only temporary. The cockroach will regain movement shortly after. Step 2, the second sting, brain manipulation. Once the cockroach is briefly immobilized, the wasp delivers a second, more precise sting directly into the cockroach's brain, specifically targeting regions responsible for escape reflexes and voluntary movement. This is where the true horror begins. The venom of Ampulex compressa contains neurotoxins, which effectively disable the cockroach's ability to initiate movement on its own. However, the cockroach is still able to walk. It just won't do so unless guided by the wasp. Scientists have studied this venom in detail and found that it blocks dopamine receptors, which are critical for self-motivated movement. Essentially, the wasp removes the cockroach's will to run away while keeping it alive and fully functional. The Walking Dead: How the Wasp Controls Its Victim. Now that the cockroach is in a zombified state, the wasp bites off the cockroach's antennae, drinking some of its hemolymph, insect blood, as a source of nutrients. It then grabs the cockroach's remaining antennae like a leash and leads it to a burrow or a pre-dug hiding place. Unlike normal cockroaches, which would normally struggle or attempt to flee, the zombified cockroach docilely follows the wasp as if it were under a spell. Once inside the burrow, the wasp lays a single egg on the cockroach's underside. Then, it seals the burrow's entrance with debris, leaving the cockroach trapped inside, alive but helpless. The larva's nightmare, eating from the inside out. After about 3 days, the wasp egg hatches into a larva, which immediately burrows into the cockroach's body. Over the next 7 to 10 days, the larva slowly feeds on the cockroach's internal organs, consuming them in a way that keeps the host alive as long as possible. This method ensures that the larva has access to fresh, living tissue instead of rotting flesh. Eventually, when the larva has eaten enough, it pupates inside the cockroach's empty shell. After a few weeks, a fully developed adult wasp emerges from the cockroach's corpse, leaving behind only the hollow exoskeleton of its former host. The cycle then repeats as the new wasp seeks out more cockroaches to zombify. What makes Ampulex compressa so unique among parasitoid wasps is the level of neurological control it exerts over its victim. Most parasitic wasps paralyze their hosts completely, preventing movement altogether. However, The emerald cockroach wasp allows the cockroach to move, but removes its ability to make decisions. This highly specialized behavior has fascinated scientists, especially those studying neurobiology and behavioral control. Researchers have even suggested that studying the wasp's venom could lead to advancements in neurological medicine, particularly in areas like Parkinson's disease and motor function disorders. Despite its terrifying abilities, Ampulex compressa poses no threat to humans. These wasps are not aggressive and will only sting if handled roughly. Even if a person is stung, the venom is not potent enough to cause serious harm, apart from mild pain and swelling. In fact, some researchers believe that these wasps could be beneficial for controlling cockroach populations in urban areas. However, due to their specialized reproductive cycle, they are not practical as a widespread pest control method. The dark beauty of evolution. The emerald cockroach wasp is a stunning example of how evolution can create bizarre and highly specialized survival strategies. Its ability to manipulate another organism's brain blurs the line between predator and parasite, making it one of the most chilling creatures in the insect world. While it may sound like something out of a science fiction horror movie, the wasp's behavior is a natural marvel, a chilling reminder of the many strange and terrifying ways that nature has evolved to sustain life.